Alan, I'm sorry, I was clutching pearls watching that. I was sitting there going, really, Newt?
What did you make of them?
Really, Newt? I mean, between Newt Gingrich, Giuliani, and Chris Christie, they've got like the trifecta of misogyny, and then you've got Newt Gingrich up here, who, didn't he leave his wife while she was dying and to marry the next wife? Give me a break, Newt. Baby, you pot meat kettle.
And the strategy, though, for fighting with, you know, Megyn Kelly again and sort of, you know, saying that Bill Clinton's going to be back in when he's not on the ballot.
You know, first of all, Bill Clinton was a extremely good president, and more importantly, the country was in a very good position when he actually walked away. And also, Bill Clinton was punished for his behavior. Everyone forgets
that. Well, Newt Gingrich was there. He was Speaker of the House, too.
Yeah, and he was doing his own stuff at that time. You know, it's always fascinating to me when they like to throw President Clinton's behavior in Secretary Clinton's face. I've never seen anything like it before in my entire career of watching a woman have to defend the behavior of her husband because she chose to make her marriage work. That is just outrageous. And again, it speaks to the sexism and the misogyny election.
Okay, so you listen, I know that you've been out there on the campaign trail with Hillary Clinton. She's had a strong few weeks winning all the debates, but taking blows on Obamacare and the WikiLeaks from her staffers, and you know that question was part of the questioning from Megyn and Newt. Are you concerned that those controversies give Trump some momentum heading into these last 2 weeks?
You know, I probably would be concerned if he knew how to stay on message, if Trump knew how to make the most of an argument against Secretary Clinton by using some of the things that have been put in the news. But Trump's own arrogance gets in the way. It's as if he steps on his own tongue regularly. There are a number of things that came out of his so-called policy speech at Gettysburg that most of the reporters were saying were really positive things, but the vast majority of the coverage had to do with him basically saying, for the first 100 days of my administration, the Trump administration, I'd be going after people who ticked me off. That tells you that he doesn't have the temperament to be president. He doesn't even have the temperament to run for president. Yeah. If you can't stay focused enough to focus on what people out there actually care about, their own lives, their health care, their education for their children, businesses that they can build, if you can't stay focused enough to put that in your speech, you can't be president.
You know what Sanford, Florida is, right?
Oh, yes.
Yeah, Sanford, Florida, it's Trayvon Martin, George
yes.
Zimmerman.
Yes.
Trayvon Martin was coming home,
yes.
some candy, and we know what happened. Well, Donald Trump said this today while in Sanford.
African Americans are living in hell in the inner cities. I mean, they're living in hell. You walk to the store for a loaf of bread, you get shot. We're going to fix our inner cities. We're going to fix.
Do you think he even made the connection there between?
Okay, no, he did not make the connection. But what is irritating is just another example of Donald Trump casting people as others. You know, the African Americans, the blacks, they live here, they do this. First of all, African Americans run the width and the breadth of the United States of America and across this globe. And for him to classify everyone as if someone lives in a inner city ghetto, that's the way he's been putting everything as it relates to African Americans. I was actually raised in a housing project in New Jersey. Just because you're raised in a housing project doesn't mean the housing project is raised in you. You can accomplish so much in the United States of America, and he knows African Americans who've accomplished so much. So the fact that he is using this really speaks to who he is.
Most African Americans, by the way, don't live in the inner city.
No.
And Donald Trump lives closer to the inner city than probably most Americans and most of his supporters. So he should, don't you think that he should know better?
Sometimes you say you know better, but I'm not sure that he's not staying on message. He's not appealing to me. Mm-hmm. He's not appealing to you. He's appealing to those people out in that audience who want to hear those kinds of vitriolic statements, who want raw meat. Mm-hmm. I don't really think he's trying to get the independents. I think he's trying to shore up his consumer base for whatever new product he's going to be selling.
Let's talk about how you know him personally, because you were on Celebrity Apprentice back in 2011.